Hello friends, Amy R here with Prairie Paper and Ink. More rainbow cards. Also using distress reinkers. So for today's cards, I'm using the new Waffle Flower Rustic Rainbow Wafer Die. Waffle Flower just had an amazing release, and I'll have a link to it in my blog post. So I started off with my hardboard, and I've shown this in a lot of videos. I took some painter's tape and I taped down a piece sticky side up so that it can hold all my little die cut pieces. That way I can watercolor all of the images, like all the pieces, without having to hold anything, you know, leaving any marks, stuff like that. So I die cut the little rainbow stripes a couple of times, because why not do more than one? And I taped them into place. And then my palette I showed in my last video. I created these rainbow colors using just three distress reinkers. So I picked Raspberry, Mermaid Lagoon, and Mustard Seed. And I mixed those colors together to get the orange and the green and the purple. So with a wafer die like this, you could totally just paint each stripe a solid color, or you could die cut it from solid color cardstock, pattern paper, etc., etc. Me being the way I am, I wanted to get all the colors onto these rainbow stripes, but I didn't have enough stripes for each color. So what I ended up doing was just painting the stripes with plain water first. That way it just makes the ink move, you know, smoother on the watercolor paper. And then I basically painted the edge of each stripe with a color. So that way I can get all the colors. So I started with yellow because that's just my habit. And then I added orange, I added pink, and then I went back and added green, and then the blue, and then of course purple. I didn't want to leave out the purple, but again, you could just paint solid colors and skip one of the colors. Not the end of the world, but I wanted all the colors. So I did that to the first one, and then I did the exact same thing to the second one. Painted with clean water, painted on the colors, had to add a bit more of the mustard seed reinker to my palette, because yellow gets just used up way faster than everything else. And then just picked up the colors and kept painting them onto all of these little stripes, letting them like blend into each other, all that sort of thing. So then once I finished painting all of these, I made sure they were completely dry. You want to make sure they are 100% dry, whatever die cuts you're using, anything like that. If you have them paint or stuck to painter's tape like this, you want to make sure they're dry before trying to remove them. Because if they're still wet, there is a really good chance you could tear them. So you want to make sure they're dry. So once they're dry, I just peel them off. You can use them as is. There's also a outline wafer die in this set. So I die cut the outline just from another piece of Canson XL watercolor paper. And then I just adhered all of these little stripes to that outline. So I just used some craft tacky glue and adhered them. So then once I've got everything adhered to the little outline, I'll start working on all the other little elements of my card. So I just went along, adhered all the little stripes, and then I'll repeat the process on the second little rainbow. And then for my card front, I used Waffle Flower's additional A2 layers wafer die. And I die cut some Simon Says Stamp sea glass cardstock as my background. And then the little clouds are part of the rustic rainbow die set. So I die cut some white cardstock, but I also die cut some fog gray cardstock. And then for my sentiments, I'm using the sentiment labels set that was part of Waffle Flower's last release. And in my video for that, I showed stamping this set multiple times and then die cutting it. And then I have this pile, this absolute pile of sentiments. And that little bowl, it's just a little like pinch bowl, you know, for like baking and stuff, you know, to put spices in. I buy little sets of those every once in a while and I use them in my office just to hold things like this, little embellishments, etc. So when I die cut all those sentiments, I would just put them in here, and then when I need them, I can just dump them out and play with them and pull out the sentiments I want. So that's what I did. So I've got my sentiments, and then I have my little rainbows, and I have my clouds. So now it's just a matter of like making my little card fronts, like a scene for my card fronts. So I'm using a combination of foam squares, like thin foam squares and thicker foam squares, just to give it like dimension. So I adhered the little rainbow, and then the clouds, I just kind of staggered here and there with a different thickness of foam squares. And I'm letting them hang over the edge. These sea glass backgrounds are smaller than an A2 card front. So I've got that little extra wiggle room. But also, like I've shown in videos and said in other videos, if this was like A2 size, I would have no problem just cutting off what's hanging over the edge so that it fits in an A2 envelope. But that's not a concern with these cards. So I've got all my little clouds adhered, and then I'm going to adhere my little sentiment with some foam squares as well. And then again, repeat the process with the second card front. So then once I've got my card fronts assembled, my card bases are Nina Desert Storm cardstock that I cut to 4 1/4 by 11, scored at 5 1/2. So these will be top folding A2 cards. So once I've got my card bases folded, scored, etc., I also die cut more just white cardstock with another one of the additional A2 layers rectangle wafer dies just to frame my background. Just kind of pulled in a little bit more of that white and just gave it a nice little extra. So I adhered those together, and then I'll adhere these to the card fronts or card bases. So then once I've got those adhered, I had the extra clouds that I had die cut using those little wafer dies from the gray and white cardstock. And then I also have the additional sentiments that I had in my little container. So I'm going to adhere a few of the clouds and then the sentiments to the inside of the card just to finish, you know, my little scenes. So just kind of fiddled around and figured out how I wanted those to be adhered. You know, didn't want to cover too much of the inside of the card, but as always, you need to have something on the inside of the card, or at least I do anyway. They don't feel finished without something on the inside. So I adhered the sentiments, adhered my little clouds, and then as a final bit of embellishment that I couldn't resist, also because I have, like I always say, a lifetime supply, multiple lifetime supplies of bling, I have some Studio Caudia iridescent raindrops and some Little Things by Lucy's Cards clear teardrops. So I kind of assembled those all over these cards just to add to it and also get some bling. And then those I'm just going to adhere with little dabs of craft tacky glue. And the craft tacky glue will dry clear so that the clear raindrops actually look clear. They look cloudy at first, so then you know the glue is dry when it's actually clear in the end. So went around, added those to both of these cards. And then once that glue is dry, these cards are complete. So as always, I will have a link below the video to my blog post. I will have a supply list. I'll link to the new release. I'll link to all the supplies I used, etc., etc. You can check that out in the description box below the video, and then I'll have a link to my blog post, all that info. Thank you guys so much for watching, for subscribing, thumbs upping, commenting, all of it. I very much appreciate it, and I will see you all very soon in the next video. Bye!